North Korea and the United States failed to work out differences in their working level negotiations in Stockholm, Sweden. It was the first nuclear talk since the collapse of the February Hanoi summit between US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. Despite the breakdown, however, Sweden seems to have been emerging again as a mediator between Washington and Pyongyang. This week, Korea Now will look into Sweden as a mediator between North Korea and the US. The US and North Korea held nuclear talks in Stockholm on October 5th. Stockholm was the place where North Korea's then Vice Foreign Minister Choi Soon-hee, US Special Representative Stephen Biegun, and South Korea's Chief Nuclear Envoy Lee Do-hoon had held a joint meeting in January. In other words, Stockholm became the stage for the US-North Korea talks in 9 months once again. Sweden has the trust of both the US and North Korea after establishing diplomatic ties in the 1970s. In addition, Sweden has played an active role multiple times in releasing Americans detained in North Korea. It is also a member of Neutral Relations Supervisory Commission, acting as a mediator of peace. For these reasons, Sweden might have been chosen as the stage for the US-North Korea nuclear talks. Sweden has been acting as a mediator between North Korea and the US, which have no formal diplomatic relations. Sweden established diplomatic relations with North Korea in 1973 and set up its embassy in Pyongyang in 1975 as the first of its kind among Western countries. Since then, it has been a bridge between North Korea and other countries such as the US, Canada, and Australia that have no embassy in Pyongyang. For example, Sweden actively intervened in the release of Otto Warmbier, an American college student. He died in 2017, shortly after being sent home from Pyongyang in a coma following a 17-month detention in North Korea. President Trump thanked Swedish Prime Minister Stefan Löfven for his release at the time. The Swedish government is also known to have played a major role in the release of an Australian college student in July who had been detained in North Korea. Sweden taking an active role as a mediator may also be the result of Sweden's pursuit of a diplomatic strategy of being a mediator of peace for its own interest. For Sweden, which is inferior to the UK, France, and Germany in terms of military power in Europe, such a strategy could be the most favorable diplomatic roadmap for its own country. In the same context, Sweden has been a member of the Neutral Relations Supervisory Commission, which monitors the armistice on the Korean Peninsula since its establishment. In March last year, the Swedish government invited North Korean Foreign Minister Lee Yong-ho to successfully coordinate the release of three Korean Americans who were detained in North Korea to help build trust between the US and the North. Therefore, it is no exaggeration to say that Sweden contributed in creating the atmosphere for the historic first-ever US-North Korea summit in June last year. It was Sweden as well that proposed further working-level negotiations between North Korea and the US after the breakdown of the talks last weekend. The US accepted Sweden's invitation to resume talks in 2 weeks' time, State Department spokeswoman Morgan Ortega said. But a spokesman at the North Foreign Ministry said Washington's claims about another meeting was ungrounded. Can nuclear talks between North Korea and the US, which appear to be in a deadlock situation, be resumed sometime soon with Sweden's mediation again? What are your thoughts on this? Please let me know in the comments below, and thank you for watching Korea Now.